Storyboard. This is Shivani Gharat. Now, RPG Enterprises has installed several works of art around Mumbai, representing Mumbai, its famous inhabitants and traditions, as a tribute to Mumbai's contribution to the country. And I'm standing in front of one such installation representing the famous Dabbawalas, and there are many more. For example, the cameraman representing the root or the origin of cinema, or even the tetrapod, which speaks about the seven islands of Mumbai that forms the modern day Mumbai. We speak to Harsh Goenka, Chairman RPG Enterprises, about the motive behind setting up of these installations, his love for art, and what will this do for his brand.
Mr. Goenka, the last few weeks have been very noisy in terms of positive PR for RPG with your art installations. And if I turn back the clock, there's a tremendous amount of art installations you're doing in Bombay. So why are you doing this at all?
Well, I've had a passion for art from a long time. And earlier what we were doing is a lot of art exhibitions.
Correct.
Whether it was at the Jahangir Art Gallery or in GMA, we also used to hold every year art camps and the like. And then we realized that whatever one says, art is something where people don't relate easily to. And if you put it in a confined space, it doesn't have the exposure which it deserves, and it is for a limited period of time. And therefore we decided, why don't we bring art to the public in general? And that's why we started having this this entire scheme where we will make Mumbai not only Swachh Mumbai but also Sundar Mumbai.
Right.
And we started off with a few sculptures. The first one was a baby head by Chintan Upadhyay.
That was in Nariman Point.
That's right, right. Nariman Point. And then we had a rhino by Arzan Khambata.
That was almost a branding for Seat.
Yes, it was.
Right.
Except now that the branding has changed.
Right.
And now we have a couple of others. There is a yoga by the bay, as they call it. And there is a Koli,
right.
A local fisherman kind of a sculpture at Mahim. There is the famous tetrapod which signifies Mumbai.
And you have the cameraman with you.
Yes, and the cameraman,
right.
Which is there opposite Mehboob Studio. But the one which has had not found a home yet is Mr. Sachin Tendulkar, who was earlier in Worli, then moved to Nariman Point, and now it is homeless.
Right.
So what we try to do is really bring in the element of Mumbai somewhere or the other.
But why do you do this? Because it costs you money, you know, commissioning these art installations. You're going to very reputed sculptors and artists. It costs you money, it costs you a lot of effort. Like you described just now with Sachin, you're struggling to find a home for Sachin. So in terms of effort, negotiating with various government bodies to find a place to place them. So there is money, so why do you do this? How does it help RPG? How does it help your brand?
Yes, it's a lot of effort, because getting through the government authorities has been a major pain area.
Right.
But we do feel there is a brand rub off.
Right.
Because what we are trying to do is create a softer image as far as the group is concerned.
Right.
And we believe that the city of Mumbai doesn't have too many landmarks to go to.
Right.
I'm always at a loss if a visitor comes, where should I take him?
Mm.
Except Elephanta Caves, I can't think of a second spot. So there was a need to create some landmark, and until the Shivaji statue comes in,
right.
We said let's create these statues, sculptures all over the city, and I do believe it has started creating a dialogue between people. There are some who love it and some who simply hate it,
right.
And which is all right.
Right.
There is a particular one of Valai Shende, a very well-known artist, which is there at Haji Ali. And the problem has been, you know, it's a dabbawala.
Right.
And so he had a stomach, him holding a stomach, and the people objected, how can he hold a stomach? He's supposed to hold a tiffin dabba. Carrier or a dabba. And it was changed because there was some sort of a public outroar.
Yeah.
But that's all right. I think it's important for people to react, people to engage, to like and not like, and that's the story about art. What is good to you may not be good to me, but as far as branding is concerned, yes, it shows RPG as a responsible brand who's trying to do its part to beautify the city, and along with some of the other CSR activities that we continue to do, whether it be on livelihood or on blindness, I think there is a space for somebody to improve the aesthetics of a city where we live.
Right.
And that's the kind of role that RPG, I feel, plays.
Yeah. You know, you mentioned Mumbai three times, and now you said city where we live. So are you saying that what you're doing is going to be limited to Mumbai, or can we see this, for example, going back to your hometown, which is Kolkata, or other parts of the country? Can we see this art effort? Because the reasons for which you wanted to bring it to Bombay, those same reasons exist in other cities as well.
I totally agree with you. But I think first we have to exhaust Mumbai,
right,
before we move on to other cities like Delhi or Kolkata.
Right.
There is so much more to do. There are so many more spaces. And it's not easy getting through the government hassles. So dissipating our energies to various cities, I don't think will be productive. First, let's exhaust one city before we move to another city.
Right.
And this is where the corporate headquarters of RPG is today.
Right.
Earlier it was Calcutta. So to that extent, you know, being in the headquarters city and being in where the commercial capital is makes a lot of sense.
Right. Now, so from what you're saying, I sense that this started off more as a project of passion, and later, okay, you are getting benefits, so you're delighted with it. Is am I reading that right, or?
Not exactly true.
Right.
It is the RPG branding is extremely important.
Right.
We don't overbrand in terms of it loudly saying RPG.
Sure.
There is a subtle branding involved, but there is a certain consciousness in the common man that here is an organization which is trying to do something in terms of improving the aesthetics of the city. So I think the first thing is the branding effort, and the second would be my own personal interest in art.
Right. Have you made any effort or investment in trying to measure how people are reacting to this? Or is it anecdotal? For example, I tell you I like it and so on and so forth.
Yeah, it's absolutely anecdotal. Mm. And I have found that half the people love some of the sculptures.
Right. And but much like art, I guess.
Yeah, absolutely. But the one which has had universal appeal, I would say, is the Dabbawala.
Right.
I think he's such an endearing part of our city. And coming from Valai Shende, being where the nerve center of the city is and having quite a gigantic presence, there is people by and large have really liked that sculpture.
Right. Now, in choosing the art pieces and the artists themselves, so is that your direct remit, that is your passion comes to the fore, or is that something your COPCOM team does? Or
no, I have personally, I think I know more about art than the corporate communications, and I have relationships with a lot of the artists. But the challenge which I have is to bring it to a common denominator.
Right.
Because art is can be very esoteric.
Right.
And there, if we create esoteric pieces, the common man.
So it has to be inclusive art.
It has to be inclusive art, and that's extremely important. And I have heard a lot of the people who are from the elite art circle think that much of the art that has been done by RPG is not great art. But
right.
So be it.
Mm.
It doesn't need to be great art from a classic point of view. What is important is that the common man sees it and engages with it.
Right.
That's very important as far as I'm concerned.
It is time for us to take a short break, but this conversation will continue as we drive to another installation. You don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.